So Devin Haney did an interview, and he says, I want to look at myself. Where did I go wrong about the Ryan fight? I was trying to figure it out. I couldn't figure it out. It's just hard to beat a guy that's on dope, that's doping. So Ryan responded, shut the F up. No amount of dope told you to drop your F in hand. And by the way, that's the reason you're a Diddy side piece. Can't take a loss like a man. What do you say about that?
Ryan went too hard on him. But Ryan's right. There's no, he didn't lose to Ryan. Ryan beat him because Ryan hits hard and Ryan's fast and he caught him. He dropped his hand and Ryan caught him. It's not because he's on something. No. Haney went in the ring and before the fight, nobody knew. Nobody knew he was on something. So that's not an excuse to say, oh, I lost to him. He beat me because I couldn't figure him out because he was on something. No. I think Ryan was Ryan. Fucking counter that left hooks, fast motherfucker, hits hard, and that's it. Haney did, dropped his hand when he threw his jab, and it happened. It's not because he was on something or he was on nothing. I think same results would have happened if Ryan would have been clean also. But can he do better in the rematch? 100%.
You believe so? I believe Ryan will do better because Ryan was gassed out.
I think Haney could do better in the rematch.
I don't know.
If he trains good, listens, and does what he's supposed to, he could do better.
I don't think they'll ever have a rematch, but let's
maybe
see.
Maybe not. But he could do better.
So Haney says he was supposed to be back in October and that Saudi offered Teofimo a fight, but Tio said he wasn't ready. Now I have to talk
to
Tio.
Mañana.
I don't know if that's true or not. Good seeing you, Tio.
You too.
In any event, you have a lot of people at the gym that could fight Haney.
Huh?
Who would you have at your gym that could fight Haney right now?
I have a lot of 140 pounders.
Okay, who? Rayo.
Lindolfo. Rayo. Brandon Lee. Jose Ramirez.
Duarte.
That's five right there.
Did anybody call you about any of those guys?
No.
Why not? Bam, would you like to fight Devin Haney? I'm putting my money on Bam. Why?
Devin Haney's a fucking 140 pounder, really.
But he can't crack an egg.
Shit.
Do you think you beat him?
Bam probably will beat him. No.
Robert says you probably do beat him. I believe Robert. I didn't say he's not your boy. So Mike Tyson told me sometimes you fight your best friends. Mike Tyson said he'd fight his own mom.
He's not in my weight class, so.
Well, you can move up. You're going to be like Pacquiao. You're going to move up. 18, 20. Robert. He's going to be like Pacquiao. 18, 22, 26, 30, 35, 40, 47. Maybe even 54.
That's pushing it.
He can do it.
130 the most.
Switch.
That's pushing it. 130 is enough.
How did Manny do it?
Manny did it. But Manny's 45 and still trying to do it. Bam, by that time, he'll be retired fucking 15 years. Right, Bam?
What's up?
He's retiring in 6 years, I heard.
30.
Yeah.
Right, Bam? 30. So all this is coming before 30.
But can I tell you something I learned about boxing? No one ever retires. Even if you announce your retirement, someone's going to call you and say, hey, I have a payday for you for 50, 20 million. You're not coming out? Exactly.
So Mikey didn't come back. I never came back and I was 26.
Did they offer you 15 million?
Look, I'm going to tell you. No. Come on. No. But at that time, good money.
Okay.
Better fights. Yeah. I told you I think I've told you before. I retired when I was 26.
Yeah.
4 years later, I was 30. And I had a good talk with Gennaro Hernandez before he passed. Rest in peace, my friend Gennaro. And he told me, because, we used to talk to each other on the phone a lot. And he asked, what you been doing? I said, we're just hanging out, going to the gym with my dad, helping out with the kids. And I asked him, what are you doing? He's like, I'm training. Because he's like 8 years older than me. He was like 8 years older than me. And he's like, I'm training. I'm like, why? He's like, Robert, at 130 right now, at our weight division. He says, right now, there's so much fucking money. Barrera, Morales, Pacquiao, Marquez, they were all fighting. That's the time where they were all fighting. Around that, he's like,
search.
If I get a good top round, will give me a good win, and they'll give me at least a million to fight any of those guys. And he's like, why don't you do it? You're younger than me. He says, he told me, you're younger than me, and you're still fresh. top rank will give you one or two wins, and then they'll fight you against one of those guys, because those guys were all fighting for top rank. And that's at least $1 million. I'm like, that doesn't interest me. It doesn't interest me. It's like Mike.
Yeah.
Last year, last May, not this last, but May of 2023,
yeah.
I told Mikey, Mikey, give me 1 year. It's May. By next May, you'll have two fights. But in those two fights, you're going to have two big fucking fights, big paydays, and you know, and I think you could win. I think you could, you know, I think you'll win. Just give me 1 year of your life, of your career, you know. And he's like, nah, I don't want to. And I said, because 1 year goes by like this. And by next year in May, I'm going to remind you. I said, look, Mike, see, I told you last year. And I reminded him this May. I said, Mikey, remember I told you? He's like, yeah, but I didn't have interest. Mikey could have made $20 million.
You're right. I take it back because I remember Chino Maidana.
Yeah.
They offered him three fights against three crash dummies, like super easy fights. But he just needs to show up and he gets paid. It was $8 million, right?
Nine million.
And he said, no, I'm not. He but these no. were the easiest fights in the history of the world.
And he said, no. So it is true. Yeah. So when Bam's 30, if he already... You know,
established.
He already told your dad, right?
Huh?
It was to your dad, right?
What?
You told him that you won't fight past 30?
Yeah.
So, you know, so... You think at 30, he's still not going to have big fights out there?
30s are the new 20s. He'll have big fights for another 20 years.
But you know, but he might say, no, I already said it, and it's not going to happen anymore. It doesn't matter. Because, you know, Mikey said it.
Yeah.
I said it, not in that level. But did Maidana said it? Fucking, that was a lot of fucking money.
Every fighter in every level thinks of quitting at some point. Everybody. It's hard. There's no money. Has it happened to you as a fighter when you wanted to quit before 26? Where you just said, I don't want to be in this sport?
Yeah.
Training camp or?
Before I fought Casamayor?
Yeah.
I didn't want to fight anymore, but... Houston, Cooter, I think it was them. They had Casamayor and they called me like, hey, there's a title opportunity. I just had a good one. I had a win. I had a win in my record. After I lost my title, I got a win, something like that. I got a win, and then they got like fucking decent money. No, you know, it's going to help me. It's going to do good for me. So I went out there and fought. But I didn't really. Before that, I didn't want to fight anymore.
No, it's pretty sad when a fighter is over and he couldn't be fighting and he wants that
to.
One.
Yeah, they one have more, to. Fight. They're doing because they have to.
I see that a lot. They're a little punchy. They use them for their reputation.
It happens a lot. It happens more than. It happens a lot.
So like, why don't they have a union? Why don't they have pension? Why don't they have?
The California does.
But you have to have a certain amount of fights.
A certain amount of rounds.
Yeah, rounds.
Certain amount of rounds.
If you had enough rounds in California, you're a pro boxer, you could get paid for the state.
Yeah, the state. California state, yeah.
But it's a lot of rounds. It's like 60 pro rounds,
some
right?
rounds. In California. You have to have them in California.
Correct.
You have to have the fight in California?
No, you have to have the rounds in California.
Yeah,
so you have to be a California fighter pretty much. Where your fights, most of your fights were in California. And they have a pension for, I think it's for per month or something. How many years? I really don't know.
The LA Times called me about 2 years ago because they were looking for any fighter that qualified, and I only found one of two out of. Nobody fights here. Nobody fights here.
No, I've counted my number, my rounds, and I counted. I qualified.
Did you apply?
Because you have to be 50 some.
Oh, okay.
I think you have to be 50 some to apply.
So you qualify.
I think I do because I had a lot of fights in California.
But today fighters don't have a lot of fights here. They don't have cars. Maybe your new gym will start every week. How hard does Bam hit? Does he hit like
Bam
a 35,
for
47
a,
pounder?
It's hard. Yeah, strong kid.
We've seen those knockouts.
Strong, dedicated.
So Robert, you're squashing all beef with Gallo. No hard feelings, he could come train here. He misunderstood what you were saying.
Misunderstood, you know. Obviously, like he says on the messages, I'm not saying it. He says 30%, that's a lot.
That is a lot.
If they were taking 30% from him, that's a lot. I can't prove it either. He said it, but that's a lot. No trainer does that.
A trainer takes 10, if
that's crazy. unless Caballero's also the manager and trainer. I don't know if he had another manager or who else he has to pay. Because when you have a co-promoter too, when you have a promoter and he has to co-promote with other promoters, then that's another fucking, at least legally a 20%. Plus another 30, then you're already giving 50%. And then if you have to pay your conditioning coach, then you're fucked. If that's the case with Gallo, I'm telling you, we like Gallo. Gallo's a fucking legend, a fucking Hall of Famer. I would have Glass back if he allows us to bring Gallo over here. Would you allow us to bring Gallo over here?
Yeah, I'd be
to
cool.
Train, right? That'd be cool, right? See, so we got the green light. So Gallo, and then we take care of our fighters. Believe me, we take care of our fighters. Bam knows how good we take care of our fighters. Yeah. Everybody else knows. That's what they
You wouldn't
know,
have 80, 70, 50 fighters here if they weren't happy.
Yeah, they're all happy. We take care of our fighters.
You don't.
My fighters make most of the money. We don't keep a lot of the money. They keep most of their money.
And if they don't make a lot, you don't take a dollar.
If they don't make a lot, no. Early in their careers, I don't take their money. But when they, you know, I never make a lot because my percentages are very, 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 very low.
Why? Why not take your fair share?
Because I was a boxer too, and it's fucked up.
I agree. Promoters could take up to 33%, right? Promoters?
No, I think when you're doing a co-promotion, I think it's 20.
20.
But
managers, what's the most they could take? 30? Managers, the most by
33.
And a coach, usually it's 10, right?
10 for a trainer.
But some legends, big fighters that make 5, 10, 15 million, the coach gets a flat fee.
Okay. If a world champion already, a fucking guy making 10, 15 million, hires somebody for the first time, yes, it's also understandable to negotiate something. When Anthony Joshua hired me, you know, I didn't get 10%.
Why not? You would have gotten like 6 million walking away.
I didn't get 10%, but you know what I mean? You know, we negotiated something that I agreed and they agreed and I was happy and that's it.
Correct.
But If I started BAM since he was 15, or all these little fuckers that are here, we have fucking 30, we have 30 of these fuckers right here that are not paying me anything because I don't even ask them to pay me.
Sometimes they live rent free and everything.
I don't ask them when they fight. Sicario, Dan, others, when they fight, I don't ask them for my percentage. They never have.
Dan,
I don't ask them.
How much did you pay Robert so far from your
first?
He's never asked me for
nothing. That's amazing. Yeah. That's not normal.
And there's fighters. There's fighters like his dad. His dad, you know, not him, but his dad, after the fights, how much do we owe you, Robert? I always tell him, no, come on.
Very nice.
Ethan's dad, same thing. Ethan's dad comes to me and says, okay, Robert, what do we owe you? I said, nah, come on.
That's very nice of him.
Don't worry about it.
But that's nice that they offer, Robert.
No, I'm not saying they don't. They do.
But you choose not to take.
But I choose not to. Oh, this kid's dad right here, too. Hey, J-Lo.
His name's not J-Lo. His name is Gio. He's Filipino.
Hey, Robert, thanks for helping my son. You know, what do we owe you for his life? Like, oh, no, come on. But then his dad also tells me the same thing. You know, so it's not like they don't even offer it. No, but I tell them no.
But Robert,
I said one day.
But it's very rare, very rare in the sport. Very rare. Most people want to get paid for their work. And at least, like you said, you're doing
let's
so much.
One day, I said, I always say, let's hope one day. Let's hope one day they do.
Yeah. Like Bam was 15, he walked into your gym.
If they already signed to a tough award or work where I know they're the person, then yeah, I'll get my percentage. But it's not like it's a lot. Most of them are not even signed to a tough award. Very few of them.
They're only making, if a couple thousand, 500 a round, if that.
Chop chop.
Yeah.
After every fucking fight, he always came, he already knew the percentage.
Yeah.
So he already always came. Here, Robert, from a farmer. No, chop chop. Until I have you signed is when I'm gonna get paid.
Okay.
And now that he's signed, yeah, he's getting nice person.
He's gonna be a big superstar.
He is.
Everyone loves chop chop.
He will be a superstar. I'm telling you.